Thank you. Please rise as you are able. We begin our service tonight in the same way that we live, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We continue with our gathering litany, responsive reading of Psalm 51, printed in your bulletin. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love. In your great compassion, blot out my offenses. For I know my offenses and my sin is ever before me.
Against you only have I sinned and done what is evil in your sight. So you are justified against the sheep and right under judgment.
Indeed, I was born steeped in wickedness, a sinner from my mother's womb. Remove my sins with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be purer than snow.
Let me hear joy and gladness, that the divine will grow weary rejoice.
Hide your face from my sins, and blot out all my wickedness.
Create me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me.
Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Let me teach your ways to offenders, and sinners shall be restored to you. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise. The sacrifice of God is a troubled spirit. A troubled and broken heart, O God, you will not despise. We continue with our gathering hymn number 334, verses 1 to 3, and then the stanza marked general.
Thank you.
Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, you hate nothing you have made, and you forgive the sins of all. Create in us new and honest hearts, so that truly repenting of our sins, we may receive from you, the God of all mercy, full pardon and forgiveness, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated for the reading of our lessons.
The first lesson is from the book of Joel. A reading from Joel. Blow the trumpet in Zion, sound the alarm on my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord is coming, it is near. A day of darkness and gloom, a day of clouds and thick darkness. Like blackness spread upon the mountains, a great and powerful army comes. Their like has never been from of old, nor will it be again after them in ages to come. Yet even now, says the Lord, return to me with all your heart, with fasting, with weeping, and with mourning. Rend your hearts and not your clothing. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love, and relents from punishing. Who knows whether he will not turn and relent and leave a blessing behind him, a grain offering and drink offering for the Lord your God. Blow the trumpet in Zion, sanctify a fast, call a solemn assembly, gather the people. Sanctify the congregation, assemble the aged, gather the children, even infants at the breast. Let the bridegroom leave his room and the bride her canopy. Between the vestibule and the altar, let the priests, the ministers of the Lord, weep. Let them say, spare your people, O Lord, and do not make your heritage a mockery, a byword among the nations. Why should it be said among the peoples, where is their God? This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The second lesson is from the book of 2 Corinthians. A reading from 2 Corinthians. From now on, therefore, we regard no one from a human point of view, even though we once knew Christ from a human point of view. We know him no longer in that way. So if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, in Christ, God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and entrusting the message of reconciliation to us. So we are ambassadors for Christ, since God is making his appeal through us. We entreat you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake, he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. As we work together with him, we urge you also not to accept the grace of God in vain. For he says, in an acceptable time I have listened to you, and on a day of salvation I have helped you. See, now is the acceptable time. See, now is the day of salvation. We are putting no obstacle in anyone's way so that no fault may be found with our ministry. But as servants of God, we have commended ourselves in every way, through great endurance, in afflictions, hardships, calamities, beatings, imprisonments, riots, labors, sleepless nights, hunger, by purity, knowledge, patience, kindness, holiness of spirit, genuine love, truthful speech, and the power of God, with the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, in honor and dishonor, in ill repute and good repute. We are treated as impostors, and yet are true, as unknown, and yet are well known, as dying and see, we are alive, as punished and yet not killed, as sorrowful, sorrowful yet always rejoicing, as poor yet making many rich, as having nothing and yet possessing everything. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise for the gospel acclamation. Dear siblings in Christ, grace, mercy, and peace are yours, from God our Father, and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. If you are in need of a time for renewal, what does that look like for you? What might you choose to do and not do? While certainly this will look different for just about everyone in this room, we can assume that you might choose to do things that give you life, that help you connect back to yourself, to your friends and your family, and to your core identity as a person. You might find renewal by going on a vacation that involves a beach, warm weather, swimming, and eating good food. You may also find yourself setting aside your phone and other technology, going out into the wilderness, camping for a few days, fishing, staring at a fire, reading, looking up at the stars, paddling, and having a sleep pattern that mimics the rising and the setting of the sun. Whatever a time of renewal may look like for you, whether on a beach, out in the woods, or at your home, pay attention to what activities, places, and people give you the space and opportunity to do so, to help you connect back to what and to whom is most meaningful in your life. As you all know, today is Ash Wednesday, the beginning of the season of Lent. We journey from the remembrance of who we are today and follow Jesus to the last days of his life. As we do that, we have this unique opportunity to enter into a time of spiritual, personal, and faith renewal, remembering who we are, looking forward to new life in Christ as we are accompanied by Christ through this season of Lent and beyond. The season of Lent offers us ample time of renewal by reminding us of what it is that we do as Christians, as people of faith, as a faith community. The great thing about our passage from Matthew 6, which I learned this week, dates back centuries to this very night on Ash Wednesday, is that it outlines three specific practices for us that are already a part of who we are and what we do. First, we have almsgiving, acts of love. This practice is more than about just putting money into an offering plate or giving to organizations in our communities. This practice gives us space to give of ourselves and of our time, to work with others to provide food at the food shelf, to use our hands and feet to clear snow or build an accessible bathroom, to coach, or to sit with someone who's just having a difficult time with their mental health. The second practice is that of fasting. This is more than giving up certain food and drink for a long period of time or simply just going without it for an extended period of time like Jesus does in the wilderness. Fasting is about recognizing that there are times when we think having more will keep us full, only to realize we are emptier than when we started. Full of noise, full of food, full of wine, full of greed, full of ourselves. As Bishop Michael Reinhardt puts it, we know we cannot worship both God and money, but we're willing to give it a try. We know we should place our ultimate trust in God, but at the end of the day, we trust our wealth to deliver us. Fasting is about the recognition that we can go without certain things in our lives in order that those spaces and our places may be filled by a deeper connection with our God and with one another. Fasting is about voluntarily giving something up for a time in order to heighten our spiritual awareness and spiritual attentiveness, says Bishop Reinhardt. The final practice is that of prayer. This practice is as central to our identity as Christians as breathing is to us being alive. We pray for and about everything, everyone, and anything and anyone. We pray for guidance, discernment, courage, knowledge, understanding, patience, kindness, boldness, and all those things we heard in the 2 Corinthians reading. We also hope we spend just as much time listening to what God is telling us as we do asking God for things. Bishop Reinhardt summed up all these practices well by saying that prayer, fasting, and giving are taken for granted in Scripture and often in our lives as people of faith. They are spiritual disciplines that empty and fill us, cleanse us, and bring us closer to our God, or rather, make us more aware of the God who has been there all along. We've just been too full, too busy, too loud, too lazy, too impatient to pay attention and notice. Lent is also a time to remember our core identity. This time is not just for embracing spiritual practices, though I certainly encourage you to do so, but also taking time to remember who we are and to whom we belong. Lent, and especially Ash Wednesday, provide us with this liturgical reminder of who we are, at the core of all that we do and all that we are. In baptism, we remember that we belong to God. We mark this occasion with water being poured on our heads and marking the sign of the cross on our foreheads, as we are sealed by the Holy Spirit and marked with the cross of Christ forever. We receive new life in the waters of baptism, meaning that we also have to say goodbye to our old life. Today, we also remember not only our baptism, but also our mortality, and the eternal promise from God that we are joined together with God forever. The ashes we will soon mark on our foreheads remind us of the awesome powers of creation, of our mortality, and that through the cross, his death and resurrection, we receive new and everlasting life in Christ. Lent helps us renew our calling, the sense of being, and renew us in our identity as beloved children of God. No matter where we've been, what we've done, or how we choose to identify ourselves. Throughout this season of Lent, my encouragement to all of you is this. Take time for renewal. Take time to remember who you are, to whom you belong. Take time to embrace, discover, and rediscover your purpose and your calling. Lent is a journey of these things, of renewal, of discovery, rediscovery, and a reminder that we are unfinished in the dust. Through the dust, we are always being made new. God is breathing new life into us, into the dust, and is giving us new life. It is out of the dust that we take time to remember who we are and that we belong to God. The dust reminds us of our past, those whom are no longer with us, those who are living eternally. The dust reminds us of our present and the loved ones all around us. The dust reminds us of our future, of those loved ones yet to come, and that we will one day join those saints in light. We are unfinished in the dust. Yet the dust reminds us of who we are. We are a new creation through the dust. Through these ashes, through the dust, we remember our calling. We remember our identity. And we remember that we are dust, and to dust we shall return. Thanks be to God. Amen. We join together in singing our hymn of the day, What Wondrous Love Is This?
Thank you.
Siblings in Christ, today with the whole church on earth, we enter this time of remembering Jesus' Passover from death to life. And our life in Christ is renewed. We begin this holy season by acknowledging our need for repentance and for God's mercy. We are created to experience joy in communion with God, to love one another, and to live in harmony with creation. But our sinful rebellion separates us from God, from our neighbors, and from creation, so that we do not enjoy the life our Creator intended. As disciples of Christ, we are called to a discipline that contends against evil and resists whatever leads us away from the love of God and from the love of our neighbor. So therefore, I invite you to the discipline in the season of Lent, of self-examination and repentance, of prayer and of fasting, of sacrificial giving and works of love. Strengthened by the gifts of word and sacrament, let us continue our journey through these 40 days to the great 3 days of Jesus' death and resurrection. Please rise and turn to page 252. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most holy and merciful God, we confess to you and to one another and before the whole company of heaven that we have sinned by our faults, by our own faults, by our own most grievous faults, in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have now loved you with our whole hearts and mind and strength. We have now loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have now forgiven others as we have been forgiven. We have shut our ears to your call to serve as Christ served us. We have not been true to the mind of Christ. We have grieved your Holy Spirit. Our past unfaithfulness, pride, envy, hypocrisy, and apathy that have infected our lives, we confess to you. Our self-indulgent appetites and ways, and our exploitation of other people, we confess to you. Our negligence in prayer and in worship, and our failure to share the faith that is in us, we confess to you. Our neglect of human need and suffering, and our indifference to injustice and cruelty, we confess to you. Our false judgments, our uncharitable thoughts toward our neighbors, and our prejudice and contempt toward those who differ from us, we confess to you. Our waste and pollution of your creation, and our lack of concern for those who come after us, we confess to you. Restore us, O God, and let your anger depart from us. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have created us out of the dust of the earth. May these ashes be a sign of our mortality and penitence, reminding us that only by the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ are we given eternal life, through the same Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. At the direction of our ushers tonight, you will be invited to come forward to receive the ashes on your forehead. Please be seated. Thank you. Please rise. We continue with our litany on page 254. Accomplish in us, O God, the work of your salvation. By the cross and passion of your Son, our Savior. Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all our sins, through our Lord Jesus Christ. Strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those in need. God of unity, you gather your church and call us to return to you. Accompany us throughout our Lenten pilgrimage. Create in us clean hearts, and renew all the baptized to declare your praise. Lord, in your mercy. God of creation, renew our earth. Bring rains to parched places and heal lands affected by a changing climate, that all inhabitants of the earth experience your abundance. Lord, in your mercy. God of healing, help those who are hurting in mind, body, or spirit to know that you are present in the midst of distress. Today we especially lift up Zach, Byron, Brian, Vicki, Dick, Shannon, Mary Lou, Diane, Dave, Brenda, Kathy, and all those who name now aloud or in the silence of our hearts. Lord, in your mercy. God of peace, give voice to those on the margins and resolve the world leaders who seek to protect those most vulnerable. Loosen the bonds of injustice and bring an end to violence, oppression, and persecution. Lord, in your mercy. God of every time and place, we give thanks for all your faithful ones of every time and place. Renew us by the example of their lives of service and prayer. And at the last, bring us with them into your everlasting presence. Lord, in your mercy. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy, through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. You may be seated. As we receive our offerings, which the offering plates are at the back of the sanctuary, let us give thanks and offer a blessing upon them. God, our provider, you have not fed us with bread alone, but with the words of grace and life. Bless us and these your gifts, which we receive from your bounty. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. As we enter into our time for communion, a few instructions as we share in the Lord's Supper here tonight. You will be dismissed by our ushers, and as you come forward, you will come to our servers where you will receive the bread, and if you need gluten-free bread, please simply ask for that as there is some available. You will then take a cup and go to either the wine or the juice, and after you have received the wine or juice, you can place the used cups in the basket at the end of the first pews. If you would prefer one of the servers to come to you, simply let the ushers know and we will make sure that that happens. Or you may also request some pre-packaged communion cups and one will be provided by our usher. As a reminder, this is not my table, this is not Grace Lutheran's table, this is the Lord's table. And at the Lord's table, everyone, regardless of background or tradition, is welcome to come forward to receive Christ's body and blood in the bread and in the wine. Please rise. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. You call your people to cleanse their hearts and prepare with joy for the Paschal feast, that renewed in the gift of baptism, we may come to the fullness of your grace. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Thank you.
Please rise as you are able. Receive a blessing. You have become what you have received, the body and blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray. We give you thanks, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us with the healing power of this gift of life. In your mercy, strengthen us to this gift, in faith towards you and in fervent love toward one another, for the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Receive a benediction. May God Almighty send you light and truth to keep you all the days of your life. The hand of God protect you. God's Holy Spirit accompany you. And may God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit cause grace to be mighty upon and through you. Amen. We join together in our ascending hymn, number 326. Rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit.